right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall. There's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now. Woo! Stopping us right now, and there's no stopping us right now, and there's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now. If you live in LA, that's a little bit of a line, but it's Sadie, Ricardo, Jenny, Jana. Woo! Sadie! All right, you guys, you know how much I love that song. So, you know, it was really cute. Last night on our group call, which some of you have been on. It was so sweet. They downloaded that song because when they're having a bad day, So I want to tell you that song is called "Feel So Close" and it's by Calvin, C-A-L-V-I-N Harris. So, you know, I think it's important I really think you should download that song. So in the next couple of weeks, if you're floating around, you're going, I live in Los Angeles, this would be me, and everything's closed, I'm gonna vomit, okay? I feel so controlled right now, I wanna puke. If that would be you, I'm hanging there with your sister or brother. So if you feel that, you might wanna download that song and then go for a walk with your dog and you'll be going down the street, go like this. People going, what is wrong? I don't know what he's drinking. He'll say, I'm just listening to I Feel So Close To You Right Now by Calvin Harris. I'm so happy. Because you cannot not listen to that song and get up out your chair and dance and you'll feel happy. Something. I'm dating myself now, but anyway. So happy holidays, everybody. It's almost Christmas time. I'm so excited. You know, I want to tell you all that we have to really go inside of ourselves right now and be present. I think that's my message to you today because, you know, I always do this little thing with the universe. So it's like, what does the universe want to talk to you about or want me to talk to you about? But I want to do this today. I kind of want you guys to talk to me. So if anyone wants to volunteer to open up their mic and talk to me, I will personally send you a free autographed copy of my book. One of my books. Thank God I've got more than one. You know, I'm just one of those people that I've written four. So, you know, anyway, Truth Be Told is the one I would send you. So if you want a free copy of a book autographed with your name on it from the Lucinda Bassett, whatever that's worth, then say, hey, Lucinda, I'd like to talk to you. I'll unmic my mic and I'll let you in and we'll chat. But anyway, ask me questions today. Me, all right, Sadie, I'm gonna let you in. Now let me see, I'm gonna go down here. I'm gonna ask you to unmute. Are you there?
I'm here.
Oh my God, now I need my freaking headphones. Hold on a second. I'm doing this whole thing tomorrow with, you know, podcasts. It's going to be a big deal. And I need headphones. Sadie, sexy Sadie. Oh,
Lucinda.
I'm sure you're so sick of hearing that you want to vomit. Go ahead. Yes, darling. Okay. What can I help you with? This is your moment. Look at you. First of all, can I tell you something?
Tell me.
You are so freaking beautiful. Are you on the video too? Can you guys see Sadie?
I think they can. I was eating my soup earlier.
Yeah, but you look great. Can you see Sadie? Just tell me that. Herman, can you see Sadie? All right, we're good.
Thank you guys.
All right,
I don't have anything specific I want to tell you other than Panic to Power literally changed my life, and I bought your Midwest tapes. And
okay. I'm going to the CDs?
Yes.
Okay.
I had a crazy experience with anxiety.
Tell me what happened.
Look, I'm getting anxious now.
That's okay. You're with, you know who you're with right now? Just so you know who you're with right now. You are with the anxiety guru. Okay, so you're
the queen.
Yes, I'm the queen.
So I would say probably 6 months back, it just hit me like a train. I've always been so
outgoing. Don't say that, because I got hit by a truck a couple months ago.
Oh my gosh. Triggers.
Anyway, go ahead. You got hit by a train. And what happened?
Yeah, with anxiety, and I've always been so outgoing. I love to be social. And it just knocked me on my ass.
What happened?
Completely.
I
don't know.
Yes, you do. Where were you? Who were you with? What was going on?
I was at a funeral.
Okay. Well, first of all, that's not good. You know, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with the funeral, but that's probably not where you want to be hanging out. You want to be, you know, not anxious. Okay. So you're at a funeral. Then what happened?
It was someone really close to me. So I was just I just felt very anxious. I didn't know.
Was this a young person or an older person or?
Young.
Young.
Yeah.
Do you know what they died of?
Yes. He was my cousin, and he was an electrician.
And what did he die
of? Working, sorry.
Is a situation where he was at work and he got electrocuted or something?
Yes.
Okay. So it was unexpected and really shocking.
Yes, and I've never dealt with death ever in my family. I'm 23 years old.
I was going to ask you, how old are you? You're a baby. You're a baby. So how long ago was this? Let's go back to how long ago was this?
I want to say June.
All right. So in June, he died quickly, and you're only 23, so you're a baby, and this is a sudden death, and you had anxiety.
Yeah, but I just feared everything. Everything you talk about in Panic to Power, I completely feared. Going to work, being at work, passing out, all this stuff. And whoever's on here, I don't want to trigger you guys.
Oh, no, you're not going to trigger anybody. I've got all of you. You're all safe here with me. I'm your safe place, okay?
But,
none of you really have a safe place, but I'm probably as good as you can.
Yes, and then, so I live with my parents. I didn't want them to ever leave for work. I didn't want them to go far. I didn't want to go far. I'm very much so past that. Thank God.
Okay, let me stop you for a minute, okay? Nobody knows who you are, but let's talk about this for a minute. Can you drive? Can you fly? Are you limited at all?
I wouldn't say I could fly right now.
Oh, well, a lot of people wouldn't fly right now. But and do you avoid social gatherings? Are you taking meds? And you can just say yes, yes. We don't need to know what you're taking.
No meds.
Oh, wow.
None at all.
Okay, yeah, that's pretty impressive, Sadie. Look,
thank you.
First of all, you're only 23. And let me just stop you right now. You obviously have a predisposition for anxiety disorder. You're probably a very high-strung, high-energy person. Mm-hmm. You overthink everything. You're really creative. You think about the future all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You anticipate things. You worry about what other people think of you. You worry if you're good enough. You worry, blah, 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 okay? You everything. Have I just described you?
You just described me since the kid.
Okay, so listen, you have anxiety. You have anxiety. I don't in the DSM-3 Diagnostic and Statistical Manual would say you have anxiety disorder. I personally hate freaking labels, but I will tell you that all this is anxiety. It's it's not going to kill you. You're not losing your mind. You're not weird. You just are, first of all, you're in the middle of a pandemic.
Yeah.
And then someone who's young dies unexpectedly.
Mm-hmm.
And so, of course, you're anxious because everybody's got an Achilles heel, and your Achilles heel is your sensitive personality. You're overthinking, you're overreacting. And the fact, I love your pillow. Let me see that pillow again. I love it. I love that pillow.
With I love it too.
I love it. It's so cool. Truth is, you know, you're a sensitive, passionate person, and it's okay. Mm-hmm. And what you have to not do is be afraid and scared about it. You know, like I had someone today trying to tell me, and I'm going to go into detail. They're like, well, maybe the reason this is all so difficult is because, you know, you're because you're so strong and you're so outgoing and the way you dress, you know, maybe you need to just tone it down a little bit. And I'm like, fuck that. I'm me. You know, I like polka dot pillowcases and I like weird clothes and I like it that I'm direct and honest. And at the bottom, at the end of the day, is that you have to love yourself and you have to have integrity. I would say that's number, those are the two most important. Yeah. And luckily and hopefully for all of you, and this is really interesting, Sadie, because I'm so glad you volunteered and I will send you a free copy of my book signed and I'm gonna give you a special message because I think you're a really beautiful soul. I think a lot of what happens to all of us is we second guess ourselves. You know, like this person that you obviously loved was a relative and died and it scared you to death and you're in the middle of a pandemic and you feel scared and then you start having anxiety and then you get, and then you think, am I crazy? Am I losing my mind? Mm-hmm. You're not crazy. You're not, honey. Exactly. You're beautiful. Okay.
Thank you.
You're beautiful and you're strong and you're going to go out and do some amazing things and you're just a bebe. You're 23 years old. So give yourself a break. And I'm going to send you my book and I'm going to Brave Sadie. That's exactly right. If anybody else wants to talk to me, this is the night. I'm going to do this tonight because I want to open the forum up a little bit, give you guys an opportunity to get something to get you through the holidays that makes you feel strong. So look, this is a perfect example because there is a beautiful young woman who lost someone that she loved and her loss gave her anxiety, which is expected. And then she goes into a bit of a depression and confusion. Mm-hmm, and then she starts second guessing herself.
Yep. Exactly.
Don't do it. Look at you. Exactly. Like somebody would look at you right now and go, oh my God, look how beautiful she is. Look at that freaking polka dotted pillow. I love that fucking pillow.
I'm going to send you one.
Oh, really? Okay. I want one of those. I love it. All right, Sadie. Well, God bless you. I'm going to send you a book. Okay. Sexy.
Awesome.
Anyway, I love you. Thank you for calling in.
Love you too. Thank you, Lucinda.
All right. So, you know, the bottom line is everybody, somebody else. Okay, I'll talk to you. Okay, Maurice, privately. No. All right, Maurice, how do I turn you on? I'm going to ask you to unmute. Okay, unmute.
Okay, I'm muted.
Hi, you're good. Can you guys hear Maurice? Give me a thumbs up.
I think so. No?
Yes, we can hear you, dude.
Okay, good deal.
All right, talk to me, dude. Tell me what you tell
okay,
me. What's your question? What's your problem? In one whatever. I can do it. I got
in one whatever. Okay. Well, I think that you know, I had had this probably when I was little and just never recognized it as a kid. And I had it maybe 7-8 years ago really bad. And that's when I did your tapes and I've actually read your book, your first book.
Okay, good. Okay.
And I feel like I was pretty you know, I got over that period. And then recently, my daughter just graduated from school and she got her big girl job in Denver, which is a far cry away from me. I'm in Ohio.
I love Ohio. I'm from Ohio.
Right.
Go ahead.
And when she moved, I just had a really hard time. It was an empty nest thing. And I didn't realize how hard it would be. And mind.
Stop right there. Are you married?
No.
Are you living with anyone?
No.
So are you in a significant relationship with anyone?
Yes, I date a girl, but
okay,
I don't live with her.
You don't live with her. Okay, so how old is your daughter?
My daughter's 24.
And is she your only child?
Yes.
And she left you?
She had to get, you know, kids grow. I know.
But no, it's so hard. Are you kidding me? You must be dying. And you're not. But look. I can already tell by your energy that you're a really great dad, and she's all you've got, in a way.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, she
adores
like
you. Yeah. I mean, come on, you guys are really tight, right?
Correct.
Okay, so she moves away, and where do you live now?
In Ohio.
And where does she live?
Denver, Colorado.
Ah! Oh! Oh, God. You're probably freaking absolutely fucking devastated. Really?
I was. Yeah. Very much so. And then I would go on this tangent where I would I'd go back into my life and I would start analyzing from the time I was 7 years old on up.
Of course.
And it just got really bad. I mean, it was to the point I would, you know, I'd question my relationship. I'd question things I had done in other relationships, you know.
Of course.
And I'd feel guilty for some of the things I'd done in other relationships, which I apologized to those people later and I gave them
an apology. You know what, Maurice? Mm-hmm. Nobody's perfect.
Okay. Well, I definitely was far from, for sure.
Okay, but let's go to now. Mm-hmm. You can spend the next 3 weeks before Christmas beating the shit out of yourself for what you've done to the women in your past or in your past or whatever. Or you can say, you know what? Screw all that. I want to step up to the plate. I know you've been on here a little bit and I want to embrace my, you know, this, what this is about, you guys. This is why I felt like I needed you guys to open up. Don't let anybody change you. Like Maurice, look at you. You're a beautiful black man. You got this fabulous beanie on. You've got a beautiful body. I can just see you for a second. It's like somebody might look at me and say, look at that dress she's got on. Look at her hair. Look at, you know, whatever, man. I don't know. Yeah. And you know, who gives a shit? You have to love yourself. And here's, if you get nothing else out of this tonight, all of you, please. This is the message. I tell you this, I get messages from the universe. Love yourself and always, always operate from a place of integrity. Well, what does that mean, Lucinda? What does integrity mean? It means that this beautiful man has just opened up and said, you know what? My daughter moved away and I'm really anxious because she's, you know, she's all I've got. He didn't say it, but I could hear it, right? And I'm dating somebody, but she's not living with me. And at the end of the day, my daughter, she's my golden nugget. She's the end of my rainbow. She's my everything. I hear it. Okay. So she's not with you and Christmas is coming and there's a bunch of virus out there and you're not going to get on a plane and fly to Colorado. Maybe you will. I don't know. You'll make that decision, but.
Actually, I would. I went for Thanksgiving. I think she's coming for Christmas.
So here's the beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. You're anxious for all the right reasons. The one person that means so much to you, that you're willing to let her grow up and move away, isn't with you right now. And that's your good dad, okay? And the fact that you want to go there for Thanksgiving and she wants to come home for Christmas, those are all good signs, okay? You love each other. So don't beat yourself up and don't think you're going crazy and don't think you're not good enough because of what you did in the past. Fuck the past, man. It's gone, okay? You cannot go back and change anything. All you can do is move forward and decide right now that from now on, starting this year, this has been the most fucked up year that we've seen, I've ever seen. Although, no, that's not really my most fucked up year was when David died. But, you know, you guys didn't all go through that with me, but my kids did. But my point is, this has been a really fucked up year for the whole world. So I hope that you all walk away with something that you get. And what should you get? You should know what really makes you happy and what really matters to you. And for me, for you, Maurice, it's your daughter. And then maybe of some woman that you are dating now or, you know, down the road, maybe you want a really mature, loving relationship. Maybe you already have that with her. But the point is, the beauty of what you're going through is realizing what's important in your life. And then also realizing that maybe you fucked up somewhere in the past. Well, trust me, I fucked up a lot in the past, okay? But what matters is not the past. What matters is future. So we all have a chance. 2020, you know, like 2020 vision, it's kind of a joke amongst some of us. What it did is it opened all of our eyes and it made us all go, okay, I've made some mistakes. I've done some things right, but I'm a good person and I love myself exactly the way I am. And I want to bring people in my life that love me. Now, listen, if you're not you, but I'm saying if you're someone who struggles with shit and you're not a good person, then you have to be honest with that too. I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about any of us that are on the screen today. Like, you know, when someone said to me, maybe you need to dress differently, maybe you need to not be so confident. I'm like, I'm sorry, I am confident, and this is how I dress. And if somebody doesn't like it, I'm not going to change. Not, you know, and I think that was, I got this interesting message from the universe today. Open the forum and say to people, talk to me. I want everybody to go away feeling better tonight. And not that I can do that for all of you, but I can tell you right now, you know, okay, Carter wants to come on too. I want to say, Maurice, I can already tell who you are. You know, you're a beautiful man. You're a wonderful father. You made some mistakes along the way, as we all have. So you know what you should do? Your New Year's resolution, which we're not there, I'll still be. I'm going to be here the rest of the Christmas, so don't worry. It was so cute. Mm-hmm. My group last night was over, and they're like, well, we don't know what we're going to do now on Monday nights. We don't want you to end. And I'm like, I'm not ending. I'm on Tuesday night for free. Come on Tuesday night. And I'm not going to leave you guys. I'm not going to leave you through the holidays, you know? And Maurice, be grateful that you have your beautiful daughter. And be grateful that you have this person in your life that you're sharing your life with. Now it's time for you to step back and take a breath and say, what do I want for myself? What makes me feel good as a man, as a father? You know, how can I move forward into 2021 and operate from a place of integrity, a place that I'm proud of? And, you know, I could sit here right now if we had more time and say, and what does that look like to you? And you could tell me in 2 minutes. Matter of fact, why don't you tell me? What does that look like to you?
2021?
Yep. The new Maurice, the Maurice that has a 24-year-old daughter who had the guts to tell me, wanted to talk to me, who's in a new relationship. What does 2021 look like to you? For you?
I think 2021 looks good. I mean, it's just I'm just evolving into a different person. And I think sometimes when you evolve into a different person, I think that they're sometimes there's struggle with the change, you know, because I'm evolving into probably someone a little more mature than I have been.
Yes.
And with that, you know, there comes a little struggle because it's a little unfamiliar.
It is. It's way easier to be a badass. Badass. Look, I'm a little bit of a badass. You know,
right.
I want to be out, going out, you know, and going out, getting drinks with friends. And like, I can't do any of that. I live in LA. And also I happen to be dating this amazing guy right now who's very mature. So I had to kind of calm down, you know?
Yeah.
And it's good. I mean, I'm not calming down. I'm not going to be me, but I'm growing up. I'm growing into a different person. I want a different life now in this next phase. I'm now a grandmother. I have a beautiful, you're going to be a grandfather someday, dude. And it's life changing. And all of a sudden, you know, I just need to grow up a little bit, calm down a little bit and be really available to my daughter and my grandson. And so I appreciate where you're at. You're going to be just fine. You're a beautiful man. I'm so glad you had the courage to step up. I'm going to grab a call from Maurice. Okay. I think this is you're next. And I love you. So hang in there. You got this great daughter. Enjoy your holiday. And I'm going to send you a book signed from me. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thank you for sharing. That means so much to me. I'm going to try to find Ricardo on here if I can. You are. All right. Ricardo, dude, you're up next.
Hello.
Hi. How adorable are you? Oh my God. Are you kidding me? Like, really?
Thank you.
You can't have any problems. You're way too
young. I wish.
Yeah, exactly.
I wish, yeah.
Hi. I'm so glad you're joining us tonight. Can you guys see Ricardo? Can you see how absolutely adorable he is? Okay, he's got like a red Santa Claus sweatshirt on and everything. He's ready to go.
Let's go.
Let's do this, man. Okay, so what's Ricardo? What's the problem? I've got the solution.
Yeah, I'm honestly very new to anxiety. So it just started this year.
What happened?
And a lot of it was because I had this pain in my groin and I had to keep going to doctors. And the doctors are finding out there's nothing wrong. I took so many MRIs, so many CT scans,
been through that. Yeah.
Everything is all good, but I'm still worried. And now the pain has gone away, thank God. But still, I feel like there's something wrong with me. And I overthink a lot. And I think there's something wrong with my brain, that I'm going to get a heart attack, that this is not normal.
How old are you?
18.
Okay. Okay. Are you an overthinker?
Yes.
Are you a perfectionist?
Just
say yes. Do you overanalyze it? And again, anybody that zips their sweatshirt up to their neck is a perfectionist.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you an over, do you overanalyze everything?
Yeah.
Are you a people pleaser?
Yes.
Yes. Do you want to make everybody happy? Do you want the world to be a good place? Do you want things to be fair? Do you want other people to treat you the way you treat them? You're the perfect candidate for me. Okay. I mean, you have anxiety. You have a personality that's prone to anxiety and depression and overthinking. And so what happens is when you do that, when you think, oh my gosh, what's wrong with me? Do I have something wrong with my groin? Maybe I'm dying of cancer. Maybe I'm dying. And then you go online and you read about pain in the groin and you go, oh, maybe it's this, maybe it's that. And you release sodium lactate and adrenaline and you're overstimulated. And then you're like, oh my God, now your heart's pounding really fast and your hands are kind of sweaty. You're like, now I'm really scared. And then you're like, what the fuck? And you just added fuel to the fire and you're thinking, I'm crazy. I know I'm fucking crazy. I'm going to lose my mind. No, you're not crazy and you're not going to lose your mind. You're an 18-year-old guy who's really cute, who overthinks everything, who scares himself to death because deep down inside, you think you're not enough.
Yeah.
And you're enough. In fact, you're more than enough. You're beautiful. You're adorable. If you were my son, I'd be going, Ricardo, will you just get your shit together, man? Be a good person. Settle down. You know, if you want, you can marry. Look at me. I am old, but I'm happy. Anyway, you have anxiety, Ricardo. It's nothing. Now, I'm not going to say that the pain in your groin isn't something. But if you've had MRIs and all the tests and they're saying it's nothing, it's probably nothing. And then if you say to me it went away, well, that's just a really good sign it's probably nothing. Okay. Yeah. So the bottom line is you are scaring yourself. I'll bet you there's something going on in your life. Are you married? Are you dating someone? Are you living with someone?
No, but I've been through a couple like heartbreaks.
Okay.
And they're pretty recent too. It all kind of lined up.
Okay. And are you, what do you do? Do you go to school? Are you working? What's going on?
I go to school.
Okay. And how's your family? Your mom, your dad, your relationship?
They're all good. They're just worried for me. My dad is going through something similar as well.
What's your dad going through in brief?
Thinking that he has something wrong with his heart as well.
Gee. And did you know that anxiety is genetic? The tendency to worry is a genetic, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So it's genetic and it's biological. In other words, so if you sit and you look back and you say, you know what? My dad's a worrier, or my dad used to take Valium and drink Rolling Rock. That's how he dealt with life. And my mom dealt with life. And my mom was a worrier. I don't know. I'm just worried. I worry. I worry about your brother. I worry about this. I worry about everything. She's dead now. None of her worrying made any difference at all. Okay. We can sit and worry ourselves sick about our children and it is not going to change anything. All you can do is be a good parent because your kids are not going to learn from what you tell them. They're going to learn from what you do. And you're 18 years old, and I'm sure you've been through all kinds of shit as a person growing up. Maybe you had a perfect mom and a perfect dad. But clearly, if your dad is genetically, if your dad's prone to worrying and being a hypochondriac, which is hypochondriasis is where you worry about your health a lot. And is that something you've done before, or is it just this one incident?
Just this. So it's been spiraling. So I keep thinking it's something different every time.
Yeah, because what you do, it's called transference. So no, there's nothing wrong with your groin. Okay, well, no, but my heart's beating really fast. Maybe it's my heart.
Yeah, or my heart's hurting.
Something in my chest. Maybe I'm having a heart attack. No, you're not having a heart attack. We've checked out your heart. Oh, God, but you know what? I'm feeling really dizzy. My head hurts. Maybe I got a brain tumor. And then what's really going on is you've been through 3 bad relationships, and you're really stressing out about that and your love life and what all that means to you, what's okay, what. And so you're like all mixed up about that. But thinking, rather than try to figure out what's going on in your personal life, you'd rather fill yourself full of anxiety about, do I have cancer? Do I have a brain tumor? Do I have, you know, testicular cancer? You know, whatever.
Yeah.
Because when you worry about that, then you're so busy worrying about that, you don't worry about your relationships, which is what's really screwing with you right now, because you're 18 years old. You're a beautiful guy. You want a relationship. There's a pandemic. You don't want to be alone. You want to love somebody. And you're trying to figure out who that person is and if that person's out there and if you're enough for somebody, and you are. But rather than think about all that, you fill yourself full of shit about thinking you're dying. Does that make sense?
Yeah, totally.
Anybody else have the guts to talk? So, Maurice, you're beautiful. You're sensitive. You have great style. You're a gorgeous guy. Figure out what you need to make you happy. 2021 is going to be what for you? What's the new Maurice? Come on. Ricardo? What's the new Ricardo? Sorry. I was looking. What are you pointing at? Is your mic muted? Did I lose you? I'm muted. Oh, why did you mute yourself? Did I mute you? Here we go. Ricardo.
No, that was my fault. All right. The new Maurice. Okay.
No, the new Ricardo. Because
the Maurice new Ricardo. 2021.
You know what Maurice is doing. What are you doing?
Yeah, 2021?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to be...
authentic.
I'm going to, like, my beliefs?
I want you to be authentic right now.
Okay. I'm going to feel great. I'm going to not stress over my health. I'm an athlete. I eat healthy. There's no need to worry about my health. I'm going to find the love of my life one day. There's no rush.
Right.
Just take things slowly. Life's not perfect. Like what you said last week, I have to accept the fact that life is not perfect.
It's not about struggling and striving for the perfect life or the perfect partner or the perfect job or the perfect body. Fuck all that, okay? It's about really getting comfortable with the fact that things aren't perfect. No one's exactly perfect. You're not perfect. Life isn't perfect. There's no perfect job. There's no perfect friend. There's no perfect lover. There's no perfect anything. It's about you loving yourself. I hope you guys get this. Look at you guys. You're coming on and you're going, you're sharing yourselves with all of us. You're all beautiful. You are enough. That's it. Wear that sign on your forehead this week. I am enough. Just how I am. I'm beautiful. I'm powerful. I'm spiritual. I am God. I am strong. I am confident. I am enough. I am lovable. I am fabulous. I am fun. I am good energy. When I talk to you guys on Tuesday nights and I do the breath work and I say, I am the great I am. I call upon the great I am. You are the great I am. All of you. All of you. You are enough. You are beautiful. So am I. You know, hey, somebody might not like the way I dress, the way I talk, or the fact that I say fuck once in a while. Then that, what can I say? You know, I'm not trying to please anybody. I am trying to be the best me I can be. But I will tell you, I operate from a place of integrity. And by that, I mean, if you're in a relationship, you do not fuck around, okay? You don't lie to people. You don't play games. I hate games, okay? What I say is what I believe. If I don't know, I'm not going to tell you I do if I don't. I will find an answer for you. I am here on Tuesday nights because I want to be. I'm in the relationship with the person I'm in with because I think he's fabulous. And is he perfect? Hell no. You know, am I perfect? Hell no. And then you get scared. But what if they don't like the fact that I'm a worrier and I'm a neurotic and I'm worried about my groin? Well, then fuck them, because you are a neurotic and a worrier. And that's because you're a passionate person, Ricardo. You're passionate about everything. You're passionate about life. You're passionate about relationships. You're passionate about your health. You're passionate about zipping up your sweatshirt. And goddamn it, somebody better love you for all of that, because that is who you are. And Maurice, the same is true for you. And Sadie, you have this fucking perfect polka dot pillowcase. My God, somebody's got to go, oh my God, she's got that fucking pillowcase. I just love it when she holds that pillowcase, because then I know that she needs me. You need that person. You need the person. Can you imagine? Look at Sadie right now. Look how beautiful she is with that pillowcase. Can you imagine some asshole saying, you know what? I just hate that fucking pillowcase. Because there are people that would do that, right? You know what I'd say? Go fuck yourself. This is my pillowcase. You better love my pillowcase. And you, Ricardo, you know, you're kind of preppy looking. You got these fabulous little glasses and your sweatshirt zipped up. Somebody's got to love that that's your space. That's your energy. You're a little bit, you know, perfectionistic. You have style. You're an athlete. You know, you're a warrior. You're a warrior. You need the person that puts their arm around and says, what are you worried about right now? But I'm worried I got brain disease. No, come on, let's go take a drive and look at the sunset. Not what the fuck is wrong with you, right?
Yeah.
Don't be with that. There is nothing the fuck wrong with you. What you need this message tonight is about only allow people in your life to that are going to touch your heart. And listen, we can't unfortunately choose our brothers and our sisters and our mothers and our fathers, but we can choose the people that we allow to come into our space. And the people that come into your space need to love you 100% for who you are. Now, that doesn't mean if you're a heavy drinker or you're, you know, abusive, or then they're not supposed to go, gee, I love you anyway. They might say, hey, I want to help you. You got a problem here. You know, get it together. But the thing is, you know, we all know what our problems are. I've got problems too. Okay. I have issues about certain things and I try to get my head around it and I try to be a better person. I'm not perfect. None of us will be perfect till we're dead. And we probably won't be perfect then either. So that's not a choice we want to make. But what we do want to do, sorry, I say fuck. But you know, anyway, I do once in a while, you know, and I actually had someone say to me, you shouldn't cuss. And I'm like, you know what? I'm 64 years old. I'm going to be me because, and I go to all of you and I don't know why, you know, I always ask the universe to tell me what I'm supposed to talk about. And I think tonight it's about authenticity. It's about authenticity. It's about Sadie being Sadie and Maurice being Maurice and Ricardo being Ricardo and Jody being Jody and Jenny being Jenny and Herman being Herman. And, you know, all of you guys, I could go on and on, and Chris being Chris. I mean, it really pisses me off when someone who's beautiful in so many ways has someone tell them they're not. It's like if there's anyone in your life making you feel small or making you feel like you're not enough, fuck them. And I don't mean that, and I just mean maybe you shouldn't hang out with them so much. Maybe you need to find a different partner. I mean, listen, I've dated people who made me feel small. I dated people who made me feel like I was, you know, fucked up for being Lucinda Bassett. Like, why do you have to do that? Why do you have to be out there on Zoom? I had someone say to me when I started doing these Zoom calls, why are you doing that? You're not making any money from that. Why do you use it? An ego thing? And I'm like, what is wrong with you? I want to do this because people need help right now. They need someone to make them not feel scared. And it's all I have. I'm, you know, I can give people, I can help people feel like anxiety and fear and depression right now is normal. And don't get all scared and think you're losing your mind if you're in lockdown, because we all feel that way. And if I can give that gift to people, then why would I not do that? And that person who had the nerve to make me feel like I was wrong for doing that is out of my life. They're out of my life. Like, you know, why would I even have you in my life? You should be saying, wow, you know, that's really cool. You want me to listen in on one of your Zoom calls? How about that? That would have been nice. That was, ugh. So I'm sharing this with you. How do you deal with the guilt of telling on your parents? Okay, that's a really powerful question. Somebody just sent me, how do you deal with the guilt of telling on your parents? So that's a huge question, and it's a large can of worms. Have you heard the saying, can of worms? And first of all, I want to say, Ricardo, thank you for sharing. You're lovely. Okay.
Thank you. And I also wanted to say, thank you for doing this. I appreciate it. As well, a special thank you to Dr. Raymond Karen, who's watching this. He's the one who recommended you.
Oh, and it's amazing. Cool.
So I want to say thank you to both of you guys.
Thank you so much. Yeah. It means so much that you're here. So how do you deal with the guilt of telling on your parents? No one knows who you are. I need to know what you want to tell. Like, are they alcoholics? Are they, did they sexually abuse you? Are they, you know, just really difficult people? So that's a very loaded question, and I don't know how to answer it unless you tell me the specifics, and nobody knows you're there. But so let's just take, for example, you know, if you were sexually abused, which, you know, I doubt that's the case, but it's hard. There were a lot of people who grew up Catholic, and I've talked to who had issues with their priest, and it took them years before they told anybody, and often they don't tell anybody. I was sexually abused by a relative, okay? And I didn't tell anyone until I was 53. And the relative is not living, but it hung with me for a long time. And I had a lot of, my next book, my old book should have been called Guilt, Blame, Anger, Shame, because we all live with a lot of guilt, blame, anger, and shame. And whatever you're feeling bad about in your life, one of those things is probably in there, if not all of them. And if you were ever sexually abused as a child, you have a lot of guilt, blame, and anger, and shame. Is it my fault? Did I cause it? Did I know it was happening? Did I enjoy it? Should I have told someone? And I did tell someone. I went to my mother and said, look, this is what's going on. And she didn't believe me. And it was pretty sick. And so, you know, when it comes to how do you talk or how do you deal with the guilt of telling on your parents, it's a big platter, and it depends on what it was. And if it's just that your parents raised you poorly, and you know, one of your parents, maybe it might have been an addict or an alcoholic, and you're really pissed off. I grew up in a really dysfunctional family. I watched my daughter raising her little 6-month-old baby, and that little baby has known nothing. Actually, it's almost 8 months old now, has known nothing since the day he was born but a calm, loving life. I mean, what a perfect life. And I actually said to her the other day, God, I hope you can keep doing that, because can you imagine if we would all have been raised in this perfect, healthy, loving environment, and then we grew up and we're 22, we go off to college, and our parents are like, we love you, we believe in you, maybe you're not getting straight, maybe you didn't get into Harvard, but we don't care, just go to school, have a good time, get the best grades you can, be the best you can be. But most of us didn't get that. You know, I grew up with an alcoholic father and a neurotic mother and fucked up siblings. And here I sit, and I'm 64 years old, but I'm not dead yet, and I'm not crazy. And some people would say I'm crazy, but no, I don't think anybody would say I'm dead. And the reason I'm sharing that with you is if I can do all that, so can you. I'm no different than you. I'm here to be the light at the end of the tunnel and the path and the roadmap to how to get to where you want to be. And I think it's a really important time. And if anybody else wants to talk, please come on. I would love to talk to any of you. Ask me a question, open up your mic. I will send you a free autographed copy of my book, Truth Be Told, if you come on and talk with me. Maybe there's something that you have to share that somebody else needs to hear. But the reason I wanted to talk to you about this today is because we're coming into something really different. We're coming into a new decade, kind of. I mean, I guess 2020 was the beginning, but this is 2021. And I'm telling all of you, this all happened for a reason. And I love that Sadie said that, but the truth is, you know, 2020 was something that happened. And the guy that I date says, there's the animal kingdom and the plant kingdom and the human kingdom, and there's this new kingdom called the realm. And the realm is a kingdom where a lot of people who are scientists and doctors believe that's where infections come from. And anything that comes from the realm needs a host. And we were the host and are the host for this infection. But it's bigger than that. It's like we're being shaken up for a reason, because things were getting out of hand. You know, people were taking things for granted and living loosely and doing too many drugs and drinking too much alcohol and not giving a shit about each other and not giving a shit about themselves. And we are all kind of just, this whole year has made us step back and breathe and say, you know, what the fuck, right? You know, First of all, what the fuck, meaning the world's small. This thing has affected the whole world. And what the fuck, we're all in this together, meaning we're all affected. We're all affected. You know, you can't get on a plane and go to Italy or France or Israel because they're all locked down too. And we've all got hearts. We all go to the bathroom. We all care about our children, hopefully. We all want to be loved. We all want to be accepted. We all want someone to hold us. We're all scared. We all feel lonely. We're all depressed. We're all anxious about the future. And that's part of what this whole pandemic showed us, is how vulnerable we all are. And none of us are perfect. None of us. And I'm encouraging you and inviting you for the holiday season to open up your heart. Go look in the mirror when we get off this Zoom call tonight and see how beautiful you are, just the way you are. And, you know, listen, if there's something about you that's really fucked up, say, wow, that's really fucked up. I drink too much. Or that's really fucked up. You know, I've screwed around with my last three girlfriends. It's really fucked up. I'm 80 pounds overweight right now. It's really fucked up. I haven't worked for 2 years and I'm, you know, be honest about the bad, but also be really honest about the good. Because if you're on this Zoom call, you're probably a good person, because you're not going to hang out with me, because I'm going to sit here and talk about God and tell you how beautiful you are and try to help you grow every week. And there's got to be some part of you that wants to be a better person if you're getting on this Zoom call every Tuesday night. I believe in you. I do, or I wouldn't be sitting here. So I invite you, because we got to breathe. I've gone too long. I'm supposed to keep this to half an hour, but I suck at that right now. I invite you to go and look in the mirror tonight and see the beauty of who you are. Because first of all, you know, I freaking love beanies. So anybody that's got a beanie on is already a badass. I love beanies. I have beanies. I should start wearing beanies. But if you are lucky enough to have a child, then look at yourself in the mirror and say, have I been a good mom? Have I been a good dad? And if you have been, give yourself a thumbs up. You're not perfect. Maybe you didn't feed him organic food, okay? Maybe you didn't breastfeed. I don't know, okay? But whatever you did, you probably did something right and you might have done something wrong. But look in the mirror and say, hey, I like myself. I am enough. I'm enough for 2021. I'm enough for 2025. And I want someone to look at me and say, you know what? I like the fact that you shave your head. Or I like the fact that you zip up your sweatshirt. Or I like the fact that you like to work out. Or I like the fact that you like to wear these weird clothes. I like the fact that you don't wear a lot of makeup. Or I like the fact that you say fuck once in a while. Find that person. That's your tribe. Start looking for the people that love you just the way you are. And the people that put you down, it might be your mother and it might be your sister. I'm not saying get them out of your life, but step back and say, you know, I love you, but you have got to love me. You got to love the fact that I like to wear Ugg boots every day. You got to love the fact that, you know, I'm gay or whatever I am. But, you know, maybe, who knows? Maybe you're going through sexual things. You're a guy that wants to be a woman. Listen, I've worked with everybody. Somebody's got to let you be your authentic self. As long as you're a good person and you have integrity and you don't hurt anybody else, you know how to love, then be you. So that's my message for this particular Tuesday. I know it's pretty strong. And I think I want to share with you. Gus, you can share. Let me go to you for a minute. Let me find you and unmute you. There. Dude, can you hear me now?
Yo, what's up, Lucinda?
Yo, man, I love your beanie. Ow, yo, I love thanks. Beanies. I love guys that wear beanies. So I do wear beanies. I don't look as good. Like, I can get away with like cowboy hats, but beanies don't really work on me. I don't know. Maybe it's because my lips are too big. Anyway,
what's keep doing up, your dude? Thing, girl.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
I just want to say first, thank you so much for what you're doing, for your work. Just a real quick backdrop. So I purchased your Overcoming Stress and Anxiety probably back in like 07 or 08 or something. I don't know when you first produced it.
It was like the 90s. It's really old. Yeah.
it was like 15, maybe 17 years ago. And I was like in one of the lowest places I've ever been emotionally and spiritually, maybe then. It was weird because I kind of had my shit together, like financially or, as far on the outward, like I would dressing and
everything looked good on the surface.
Yeah. So I actually experienced sexual abuse as a child and I built this ego identity around hooking up, being like a hookup guy or whatever.
Right.
And it was like, that was what I did. And I just got to this hollow place where I desired real intimacy and I didn't know how to do it or how to get it. My family was all fucked up. Very similar actually to what you've shared, like
my
alcoholic father, neurotic mother kind of thing. And
right.
I just internalized all of those negative programs. And I remember it was my birthday and I heard a commercial for your program and it just resonated so deeply with me. And I went back in my bedroom and I called and I ordered it. And like, I was like crying and it was the first time I had felt sadness in so long. And it was just very overwhelming and that it totally changed my life. It took me, like I didn't even open the box for I don't know how long, cause I was just terrified to go into that space. And those are tools that have stuck with me ever since then. And I mean, I've been on this journey, in a lot of different ways. I guess the question I'll bring to you, the offering I have here today. So I've been through like a radical awakening here in the past. It started a little bit before the whole COVID thing for me. And I felt like, I was trying so desperately to convey some of the things that you've been sharing. And like everybody else was like, what the fuck are you talking about? And now it seems like there's more and more people, like the tribe is almost naturally gravitating together. Like the coincidences are just phenomenal, like each and every day. But my question is like, I have this heap, like a mountain of fucking negative karma that I've compiled over my life from like living out of ego and just being an asshole. And it kind of has reached a climax here. And I know a lot of people are going through different things this year. So it's not like I'm not special in that regard, but like, I feel like there's like this light, like you're talking about, like awakening to the sense that like the divine like works through us. Like, I've done so much trauma release work and stuff. Like I'm super aware and present to that every day, but like I've built this fucking like train wreck in my life, like financially, credit wise, like I've burned so many bridges. I don't even know where to begin. I'm not going to try to, but like with this awareness and this like joy, it's like an infinite and abundance that comes from within that cannot be taken. I walk out into the world and I feel like I'm, like infinite possibilities are there, but the world looks at me as like this train wreck, my family, my friends, the
system. So find new friends, new family, listen to me. No, listen, you're not a train wreck. This is the beginning. It's an open door. It's an open window. I mean, you're sharing something really beautiful here. It's like, what's the word that you use? You said like fucked up background. What do you say? All this karma.
Negative karma.
Bullshit. No, bullshit. Bullshit. Fuck it. Let it go. Okay. This is 2021. It's okay. You have all that negative stuff that happened in your life. It's not karma. I don't like that word because negative karma means it's a payback. No one's paying you back. You don't need to be paid back. All you have to do is stand here in this moment and in this space and this energy and say, I'm sorry that my life was such a train wreck, but I want to move forward and I want to operate from, this is really important. I want to move forward healthy and operating from a place of integrity. And that's the way I want to start the new year. I want to be a new me. I want to be a new man. And I'm going to start by being honest and forthright and responsible for myself. And I'm going to come from a place of integrity. You should all write that down. I want to be honest and forthright. Okay. Comfortable with myself and operate from a place of integrity at all times. Honest and forthright, comfortable with myself. I like myself. I feel good about myself. And operate from a place of integrity at all times. If you do those four things, your life will change. And the people that think you're a fuck up, stop hanging around with them. You ever hear you are who you hang out with? Okay? Get rid of those people. And I don't mean,
I've cut a lot of people out. And I
that's okay.
The point where it's like, I was feeling isolated. So I've been reconnecting with the people who show that they genuinely care.
That's what you need to do. start much a new smaller family. Circle. And I'm not saying you should get rid of your mom and dad. It's been really tough.
Like my dad's physically ill and all this shit. And I've been trying to like emotionally detach while not like completely like cutting them out.
You're coming from such a place of integrity there. The idea is that you cut people. It's not that you cut off your family. You don't want to do that. But you know, you could sit down and you could make a list right now of all the people in your life you need to cut off. You know, again, you are who you hang out with. I promise you this, you guys, when you let go of the negative, destructive people in your life, the people who make you feel like a loser, so you hang out with them because they're losers, get rid of them. And then start hanging out with people that maybe are a little bit more like you want to be. Hang around with people who believe in you. Good people, not alcoholics, not drug addicts, not abusive people. Hang around with people that want you to be a better person. And that's hard too, because when you hang out with people that want you to be a better person, then you kind of don't want to hang out with them because maybe you don't want to be a better person. Maybe you don't want to stop drinking as much or eating, you know. But the bottom line is, hang out with people who push you to be a little better so that you can be a better person. And start choosing your tribe differently. I had to let go of a lot of people in my life this past year. It was really traumatic for me because as much as I love some of these people, they were people that maybe kind of made me want to, you know, do things, party a little more, whatever, you know? And that's like this Lucinda that got hit by a truck last September.
Yo, I got hit by a truck too, actually. That's really weird.
Are you serious? Walking across the street?
Yeah, you see the scar on my head? Yo, no, I was driving. I got T-boned, but yeah.
You hit the windshield?
The side, but my head broke out the driver window. I was hospitalized. It was crazy.
All right, so I'm telling you, there's a reason that happened. There's a reason that you've talked to me. You're going to go in a different direction in 2021. And it, by the way, when the universe speaks to you and says, it is time for you to move forward. It's time for you to let go of bad habits. It's time for you to let go of bad people. It's time for you to step up to the next level of integrity and spirituality and growth. The whole world's going to open up for you. New and incredible people will come into your life that you didn't even expect. Opportunities for jobs, doors will open, windows will open. And you'll be going, wow, really? I had no idea. But it's because you're coming from a different energy space. So all of this has happened to you for a reason.
I feel that, like all those things that you're describing, like in small ways every day, that it's like weird mysteries and magic things happen. And I'm like, this is so weird. Like life feels too good to be true. But
it's
like,
not.
But,
look, trust me when I tell you this, and then we got to breathe. Things are happening for a reason. You've opened your heart, Gus. You're trusting. You know that you don't want to be what you were before. It's not karma. Don't ever use that word again. It's not about karma. The universe doesn't believe in that shit. God doesn't believe in that shit. Okay. The real I am, all the real I am and the universe wants, you were put on this planet to be joyful and happy. You were put on this planet to give, to prosper. You were put on this planet to have the things that you want. What screws us up is when we grow up in a fucked up family or people tell us we're bad people, then we do bad things and we feel like we're bad people. Guess what? You can start over now. The universe has, something has wakened you. You know, you've been awakened. I was too. And so now it's time to say, what do I want 2021 to look like for me? And it goes back to, I want to like myself. I want to love myself. I want to hang around with people who accept me for who I am. I want to be a better person. I want to be healthier. And number one, I want to have integrity. I want to come from an honest place. I want to tell the truth. I want to feel good about myself and know that no matter what I'm doing, I'm operating from a place of integrity. Does that make sense?
Totally.
You're on a really good path. I don't know where you're going, but you're going somewhere really powerful. I promise you that, okay? I can't wait to hear from you. Stay with
light
me.
What? Absolutely. I said to work light, to shine a light in the dark world. That's part of the purpose.
So it's a bright light. You know, that is our purpose. You know, I remember when my sister Donna died and I was on a plane and Sammy was 6 months old and I started crying and I'm like, who's going to be here for me? And this is a true story. And I was on the plane and I was crying. I'm like, who's going to be here for me? Who's going to be here for me? She was the one that was here for me. And I wasn't doing all the things I'm doing yet, you know, and this voice came to me on the plane and there was bad turbulence and Sammy was a baby and I was flying in for the funeral. I had just been there. And this voice came and said, you're all here for each other. You are all here for each other. You're not alone. And I got it. And little did I know I was going to go on to write all these books and be able to give some guidance to people like you. And this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. And, you know, I believe in you. You're going to be something, do something, go somewhere amazing. But just be careful about the tribe you pick. Get rid of the negative. You know, it's a new year. It's time for new beginnings. Really, ever more powerful than ever before. 2021 is a time for you to really reevaluate the new you, this new year, this new millennium, you know, everything. This all happened for a reason, and it's awakening. That's what it's all about. I've said this, and for those of you that have heard me before, the worst thing that could happen to you may not even necessarily be getting COVID. Most people are living through COVID. It'd be if you go through this whole pandemic and nothing about you changes. That would be sad. All right, you guys, let's breathe. You ready to breathe? Woo! Let's get ready. I'm going to pick a great song. I'm going to pick a song because I think it needs to be a man song. Okay, this is one of my favorite songs. All right, let me make sure I got music. The breath work's so important. So you know, one of the things I'm going to offer is I'm going to offer a 6-week breath work course where we do affirmations and we just breathe. And I do these breath work weekend retreats and we haven't been able to do them because of COVID. So in January, I'm sure it's going to sell out. So if you're at all interested, you should call Darla. I'll give you the number. It's going to be a 6-week, really intense breath work course. It's all about affirmations and taking your life to the next level and doing this breath work in a really serious way. And so Darla's number is 419-350-7499. That's 419-350-7499. I'm only doing them because I want to do them. I'm going to be so busy with these podcasts and all this other stuff. I'm not going to have a lot of time, but everybody wants to know how to breathe. And breathing is the most incredibly powerful modality that I can offer you. And most people are so scared to breathe. I want to teach you how to breathe and I want to do it. So I'm going to do this group similar to the one we did you guys on Monday nights that stopped last night. Everybody was so bummed. No, I don't want it to be over, but I'm going to do a breathwork group. So anyway, enough of that. Let's breathe. All right. Let me get my music up here. And I really want you to think going into this breath session about what the new you for 2021 is going to be. Can you hear the music? Can you hear it? Is it too loud? Everything good? You're gonna breathe in through your mouth and out through your mouth. Breathing in through your mouth to the count of three. And then a short breath out. Keep your mouth open like you're drinking out of a water bottle. Safe to breathe. Safe to let go. Safe to surrender. I call upon the great I Am, masters of light and angelic forces, to give every person present tonight a very clear sign and signal of their connection to God and their higher self. Hey! Keep your mouth open. Keep your breath consistent. Safe to surrender. Safe to trust God. Safe to let go. Call upon the great I Am, Masters of Light and Angelic Forces, to give everyone here any information, signs, or answers that they may need to hear tonight. What is 2021 going to mean to you? How will you change your life? I Am, Masters of Light and Angelic Forces, to show everyone here tonight the beautiful light of their soul. This is your spirit. This is your light. This is the energy that you have to share with the world. With this energy, anything is possible. I invite you now to come back to the space. You are all so beautiful. You are all so lovely. You are all, you know, gifts from the universe. You have so much to offer. So please stay focused. Stay positive in the next couple of weeks through this time. We're moving into a very spiritual holiday for many people. We're moving into Jewish holidays and Christian holidays and a lot of other holidays. But the most important thing is, you know, it's the holidays and it's time to share and it's time to work miracles for other people in your life. And it's time to be grateful and stay in gratitude. So I love you all so much. Thank you for sharing tonight. Those of you who did, I'll make sure that Darla gets all of you. Ricardo, Sadie, and Gus, you're going to all get a signed book from me. And I will be here next Tuesday. Don't you worry, okay? I'm not going to leave you. And Herman, I'll see you next week too. Woo! Peace out, guys. Take care of yourself and those you love. And stay positive.